Welcome to the Mercator GIS Lab video tutorial, a tour of the Planetary Geologic Mapping Python Toolbox. The PGM Toolbox is simply a collection of Python tools that support common GIS workflows and best practices and is publicly available at the Mercator GIS Tools website. Python tools operate like any other geoprocessing tool and can be executed from wherever the toolbox is saved. Today we'll demonstrate how each tool may be used as well as some of their limitations. The first tool we'll demonstrate is the Merge Files tool. This may be used when data saved as separate files need to be merged into one. In this example, the geologic units of the map are saved out as separate shapefiles, and we need them together in one feature class. The first thing you'll want to do is open the Show Help window, which provides useful information about each parameter. I'll set the workspace where the files are located. If I only want to merge certain files in that workspace, then I can add it to the optional filter, for example, *.shp for just shapefiles, and then set the geometry type. If files are stored in subfolders within the workspace, check the box to enable the recursive search option. Lastly, set the output feature class and run. You'll see in the output feature class that all common fields have been retained and a new field named file name has been populated with the name of the input files. Next, we'll use the Topology Check tool to test our contact line work before building geologic units. Topology is simply using rules to define the spatial relationships features may have based on the logic associated with that type of data and the geometry. It's a powerful but largely unknown concept to most GIS users, largely because of how confusing it can be to set up. To help with this, the Topology Check tool creates a new topology class, adds the feature class, appropriate rules for the geometry type of the feature, and validates it. For polygons, the rules are must not overlap and must not have gaps. And for lines, they are must not have dangles, must not have pseudonodes, must not intersect, and must not self-overlap. What users still need to understand, though, are some of the requirements and limitations to working with the topology class. Namely, the topology can only be created in a geodatabase, i.e. no shapefiles, and that a feature class can only participate in one topology at a time. This means that once the tool is run and topology class is created, it must be revalidated through the catalog window. If it's run again without deleting the topology class and the ancillary output feature classes, the tool will fail. The parameters for this tool are simple: the input data set and the cluster tolerance, which is the distance at which points are considered coincidental. This may be increased as scale decreases, but we typically recommend leaving it empty. Once the tool is executed, dirty areas are identified by red points, lines, or areas, but the actual error features are written out to the associated output feature classes, which end in underscore line, poly, or point. Here we can see that a number of pseudonodes have been identified, but have already verified that they are points where different contact types come together and not actual errors. There is one error, though, and we'll correct it now. To do so, we'll zoom into the feature, begin editing the contact feature class, adjust the vertices, and snap it to the adjacent vertex, then save our edits and close. Again, if we wanted to verify that all errors were corrected, we would right-click on the topology class and select Validate. With good contacts, we're ready to build geologic units. The first time contacts are converted to units, they must be attributed by hand, But once the iterative editing process begins, it's much easier to edit the contacts and carry forward existing units so that only the changes have to be addressed. This tool automates the process of converting polygons to points and then converting lines to polygons while carrying forward the attributes from the points. The parameters for this tool are also very simple. The input line feature class, the optional polygon feature class, in this case, the geologic units created from the merge files tool, but in practice, the last version of your geologic units, and output feature class. We recommend you follow a versioning convention that makes it easy to determine the most current units. If this were the first iteration and there were no units to carry forward, then we would omit the input polygons and the resulting polygon feature class would have a new text field named type, ready for attribution. The last tool we'll demonstrate is a slope and aspect tool, a more specialized tool that can quickly determine slope or aspect for points, typically the results of strike and dip analyses. Opening the tool, we see the parameters include input point feature class, field containing the original values, DEM to be used for the analysis, the test type, and then the output feature class. The output of the tool is a duplicate of the input points along with the original values and calculated slope or aspect values, which allow for a number of comparative analyses. The Planetary Geologic Mapping Python Toolbox was created as a living product, which will be maintained as bugs are identified and expanded for additional use cases, but we hope that users will continue to suggest ideas that may be useful for the Planetary Geologic Mapping community. More advanced users may want to modify these tools for their own uses, and as part of the public domain, this toolbox is freely available for modification. We just ask that the original authors are cited. As always, we hope this has been helpful for your mapping endeavors. Please feel free to contact either Trent or Mark directly with feedback, questions, or recommendations for new tools. Thank you.